To other news tonight, Q2's Scott Breen recently in Los Angeles. He had a chance to visit the Late Late Show with James Corden, which airs right here on CBS, who's the right-hand man, the unpredictable Reggie Watts. He also grew up in Great Falls.
Ah, good to see you. You look great.
Just a few minutes before showtime on a Monday, Reggie heard I was in the green room and unexpectedly walked out to introduce himself. And check out the shirt. How's that for a shout out to Big Sky Country? Then he wandered off and hammered out a show featuring the two main characters from the new Tomb Raider.
Womb Raiders!
Right after, he's back and spent almost a half hour with me. First question, had anybody ever confused him with NBA player James Harden?
I mean, I sometimes am him. We switch consciousness, so we are kind of the same person. But no, you're the first person to tell me. I didn't think anybody noticed.
And there's your first sample of his sense of humor. Watts admits he's not much of a sports fan, but did suit up at Great Falls High for the Bison football team once.
I mainly just wanted to play football because I wanted to like do that classic high school, like, I'm on the football team or whatever type of thing. I didn't memorize any of the plays. I played right guard. I only picked right guard because there was a deodorant named right guard. Yeah, and I would hide from the coach to make sure that they just never would see me so that they wouldn't be reminded to call me out to the field because I didn't know any of the plays because I never studied them.
He says it was part of a plan to spend his high school years just sampling everything, sports and band and, well, you know.
In second year, I was like in student government and like lost a bunch of weight and like was like modeling a little bit for the school paper and like all this like stuff. I was in the yearbook drama team. We went against your school, Billings West, and won three categories out of the five. That was pretty amazing. It was a cool year. I didn't really have any social class. I was hanging out with my friend John Thomas, my friend Steve Morse. I was just kind of everything, but I ended up being kind of like a weirdo, kind of goth, new waiver kid.
All that sampling led Watts into music, comedy, and now late night television on CBS, though he says this was never really on his radar.
I knew I wanted to make people laugh, and I wanted to, like, you know, make cool things that people could experience. I didn't see it going here. There was never a plan to be on television.
The one, the only, James Corden!
His MO now is throwing people for a loop.
Reggie, you're an only child, aren't you?
Me?
Yeah.
I'm the first, middle, and last child.
Ah!
Be it stand-up comedy or freestyling songs with random, silly lyrics. By this point in the story, you have to be wondering somewhat about those locks of hair.
I remember just making no effort to do anything to my hair when I moved to Seattle in 1990. So I was like, ah, screw it. So I just started growing out my hair. And it was funny because like you could see the relaxed part kind of growing out with like the real hair. So my hair looked totally crazy, but I loved it. And I just kept growing it out.
So here we are, CBS Los Angeles, where they record the James Corden Show. And one of his most popular segments, obviously, carpool karaoke. Now, as musically inclined as Reggie Watts is, does it often strike him as sad that he's not invited along?
No, because I'm an improviser, so it's tough to... I mean, if we were doing one where I was allowed to completely destroy things, then, yeah, that would be great. Otherwise, that's his thing, and... God bless us, everyone.
This is a single off his new album coming out next month, Casual High Technology. It's an electronic dance collaboration with longtime friend John Tejada. They combine their names to come up with the band name, Wahada.
They're just tracks. They're kind of architectural compositions. We created this music. We were like, oh, screw it. Let's release it. We'll call it Wahada. It'll be a mixture of our last names. And we found a label that could move as quickly as we wanted to move to get it out, as fast as we wanted to get it out.
2 weeks before his music release, Comedy Central unveils this new show starring the Great Falls native.
Taskmaster.
That's me. I'm the Taskmaster.
And I'm the Task Assistant.
That doesn't exist. It's this fun show that has a bunch of recognizable people from various fields, like a DJ and a stand-up comedian, some actors and things like that. It's just funny to see people out of their element. People that you know might know is like, oh, he's a really cool DJ producer. And now he's like doing these silly tasks. And you're like, oh, that's what he's like.
In Los Angeles, Scott Breen, MTN News.
What an eccentric cat. Taskmaster debuts 2 weeks from Friday on Comedy Central. His album comes out May 11th, but you can pre-order right now on iTunes. Reggie's mom and a couple other longtime friends are still in Great Falls, and he makes it home a few times a year to perform even here in Montana.